What is this piece of hair doing? Stay over there. No? Okay, fine. Hi guys, hope everyone's having a nice day. I am doing another small Lush haul from the Lush Oxford Street. So, to start off with, it's going to be a bit of a short video. I haven't got much stuff. So yes, to start off, I'm going to be showing you this one. This is called the Respect Your Elders soap. So cool. Look at it. Let me just bring it closer for you to see. It's a very bumpy type texture. Smells very nice. Smells a bit like blackberries and a bit like wine. It smells very like berry-ish, basically. The ingredients in here, you have elderflower infusion, which is really nice, very fresh. It also softens and soothes the skin. You've also got elderberries too and bergamot oil. And that basically uplifts and cleanses and soothes your skin. You've also got butcher oil in there, also same to the comforter and the You Snap the Whip. And that basically has got a black currant kind of smell, and it's anti-inflammatory, which is great too. Great on rashes. And you've got cypress oil in there as well. And that is an antiseptic and also tones the skin at the same time. So it's very good. It is basically a piece of soap. So I do feel like when I use soap, my skin kind of gets that kind of squeaky clean kind of feeling. But it's all right. You can always add a moisturizer on top. I wouldn't use this the whole thing in the shower. Cut it up. Because if you use the whole thing, it's water-based. So basically it'll erode very quickly in the shower. So yeah, just take like a little slither in, cut it in half, then you can use it. Stick it in your loofah and it'll make your skin really, really, really nice. Next I have is the Tangled. I think you've seen this before. This is basically a hot oil treatment. It's really, really beautiful. That's what it looks like here. And to the side, it's like a hexagon kind of shape, honeycomb shape. And inside of here, you have extra virgin olive oil, which is great for really moisturizing your hair. You've got organic jojoba oil, organic jojoba oil in here, and that conditions your hair too. You've also got orange flower absolute, which is lovely. It smells very like lang langy, which is nice. But the orange flower in here, there's an antiseptic purposes, and it also tones and uplifts your hair, gives you a bit of volume too. And you've got lang lang oil in here as well, which is sweet and floral. So your hair does smell very sweet and very floral afterwards, which is nice. Next I have is the Waves. Look at this. This is the Waves shampoo. It smells like Scenic, if you ever smelled that one before. It's very nice. If you don't have this one, you can always use Scenic. But in here, it's got very big chunks of sea salt, I'm assuming, in here. You've got hand-harvested sea salt, which is great because it's also used in big shampoo, and that adds volume to your hair, so it does waves volume. And that one basically also revives itchy scalp, which is good too. So make sure you do wash it all out because it may, you know, itch. Also improves circulation too in your hair. You've got Irish moss powder in this too as well, and that gives a lot of texture to the hair. You've also got lavender oil in here too. It smells a bit lavendery. It's kind of a bit more seaside-y than lavender. And that one is an antiseptic, it's also antibacterial, and it's very relaxing too. So it's good to use at the end of the night as well. If you've had a long day, stick this in your head. It's basically like a bar of soap, so wet under the water, go like this in your hair, and that'll basically give it a lot of texture, give it a lot of volume, put some waves back into your hair. Next I have is the Pumice Power. This is the foot soap slash scrub. And it's my favourite scent ever. It's of Brightside and it's beautiful. So amazing. Good to use. It's basically a pumice stone. So you use it, it's basically, pretend this is your foot, scrub the crap out of it, scrub the pants out of it, and it'll make your feet nice and soft and beautiful. This basically has sweet, organic sweet orange oil in here. So it's very sweet. It's got pumice powder too. That is a very good exfoliation, and it smells exactly like Brightside. So what more do you want? Next I have is the Experimenter, the beautiful bath bomb. You might have seen it before in my Lush haul from Oxford Street, which I'll link down below for you. But this one is beautiful. It's so, so, so smoky. It is beautiful. Sorry for being beautiful too many times. But basically, it's got popping candy in here for a really nice kind of bath time experience. You got vetiver oil in here as well, which is an earthy, kind of smoky aroma. That's what you can smell mostly. Each section apparently smells like something different, which it does. This one's a lot more calmed down than this side. This one's quite smoky. It just smells smoky, basically, to me. You've also got Tonka Absolute in here, which is antiseptic and antispasmodic too. And you have Fairtrade Vanilla Absolute, which is a fragrance. So you've got a very smoky, sweet kind of scent. So nice. Can't wait to use this in the bar. And it's got glitter, which is great because I love glitter. Although I do feel like when you use glitter too much, you get quite itchy skin. So make sure you just kind of like pace yourself with your glitter. Mm. Next I have is the... Dun, dun, dun. The miniature comforter. I know it's a bit of a kink. Let me just open it and then it'll pop. There we go. So this is the little miniature comforter. It is a moisturizing shower cream. Beautiful. It's like literally, ugh, crap. It's stuff on me. I've used it before, so it's a bit wet. But it has got blackberry and vanilla infusion. It's also got almond oil in there, so it's very soothing and hydrating. You've got bergamot oil in there, so it's very uplifting, cleansing and soothing. Great for you for have like a sunburn. Apparently it's really nice for using when you have a sunburn because it'll soothe all out. Cassis Absolute in there, so it kind of gives a more fruity kind of smell. And you have cypress oil, which turns your skin and also is an antiseptic, so it's great. Next, I have, it's in bath bomb, Guardians of the Forest. It's based on the movie Guardians of the Galaxy. It smells so earthy. It smells a bit like grass meets green bubble room. Really nice. You've got cypress oil in there, like I said before. It's antiseptic and also tones the skin. You've got lime oil in there, so it's quite, it's a bit citrusy as well. So that's also helps with circulation and it tones your skin too, just like before. And you've also got rosewood oil in there. And that, it basically uplifts your skin and is also antiseptic. So it's great if you're using it in the mornings, if you're gonna go for your day, or even if you're ill. And it's quite a strong fragrance. It's a bit subtle actually. And it'll really awaken up your skin, awaken your nasal passages. You'll just feel good basically. Next. I have is Life's a Beach, which I love the name of it because it's beautiful. And inside, actually, it's a body scrub powder. The little thing on this says, everyone loves a salty splash. Get in the nude and scrub with vanilla-y sand. And then literally, oh, I can't, I'm just going to eat this. I'm just going to stick my nose in there all day. It smells like vanilla-y. Oh, it's beautiful. And it actually looks like sand. How cool is that? I'm going to use this today and I'll do a little demo on it too. It's got a fine sea salt in there, which is good for exfoliation and it's good for itchy skin too. You've got sand for an exfoliation too. Jasmine Absolute is good for sensitive skin, which is great because if you've got like a sunburn, that'd be really nice. Very light exfoliation too, which you don't want to put too much pressure. Tonka Absolute is there as well, antipasmotic and anti-inflammatory, great for sunburns, like I said. And Fairtrade Vanilla Absolute, which is great for the fragrance. It just smells like you want to eat it. Don't eat it. Actually, let's see how it tastes. It's got sand in there too. Tastes horrible. Anyway. Next, I have, oh, I can't get out of my mouth now. Next and lastly, I have is the Love and Light hand cream. This, I'm not a huge fan of the smell. It smells very neroli, which is not really my type of taste. Maybe if I do, maybe in my 100 subscribers, I know I'm only on 25, but in my 100 subscribers, I'll do a giveaway of my Lush products, and this might be featured. So the little thing on here, it says the softening neroli and fairly traded cocoa buttercream will make light work for moisturizing your hands. That's what it looks like. Really neroli. Let me see what it looks like on my skin. Like that much. It's very light as I can feel it now. I'm not a fan, but it's cool. Someone else will use it. Inside it has the jojoba oil, which is great for conditioning your skin. Amazing, goes into those nooks and crannies. Got the fair trade cocoa butter in there to moisturize your skin too. Neroli oil is great, uplifts, soothes, and it's fragrance as well. And most of all, it's got Brazilian orange oil in here too for anti-inflammatory, and it's also antiseptic. So it's great if you have little rashes on your skin and you're a bit sensitive, so it'll be really nice. So yes, that is the end of my little miniature Lush haul. I know it was very quick, I went through that, but you got all the information and you should go outside and get some. I think once the I know the list that's going to be replaced for the Lush stuff that's getting discontinued, I shall upload one about the list. Okay, great. So everyone have a lovely day and enjoy the rain. Hopefully it's not raining where you are. Please don't be raining where you are. And hope everyone has hugs and kisses around.